One of the principal purposes of a prenuptial agreement is going to be to identify and preserve separate property. But when a lawyer is drafting a prenuptial agreement, they really have to think ahead and anticipate the situations where couples are very likely to commingle, transmute, and retitle their property. And so it's not that unusual to encounter prenuptial agreements where the drafting doesn't totally cover, it leaves ambiguities. It may be internally inconsistent, or it may have failed to anticipate circumstances that arose during the marriage. And so these tracing concepts come into play when you're protecting. Let's say, for example, you have the spouse who was protecting a trust or protecting family money, inheritance that they may have received, and then placed into starting a business. Now, here in Pennsylvania, there's a presumption that if property was acquired during the marriage, it's presumed to be marital property, and you have to overcome that presumption in order to prove that it's separate property. So if this business was started during the marriage, then the business owner has to overcome the presumption by a preponderance of evidence to show that it can be traced back to separate property that's protected. And that's where these tracing concepts come into play. It's where FIFO comes into play and the discovery comes into play and some other things.
So Brian,
one
of the big disputes we have going right now in Ohio, and I think I know how Pennsylvania would handle it, is where one spouse inherits a business interest from a family company. So it's grandfather to father to son. Son inherits an interest in the family business. From the date of that inheritance until the date of the divorce, the value of the company increases by $1 million. That spouse is the CEO, CFO, president, you know, high power executive in that company. How would Pennsylvania handle that appreciation on the value of the business?
Here it's fairly simple, because all we really have to do is measure the value on the date of separation and measure the value on the date of the marriage or gift, whichever the acquisition was, and subtract. And it's as simple as that. We don't have to separate into active and passive. That's a difference from Ohio. Now, a business owner who is, I think you said, third or fourth generation, is likely to have a prenuptial agreement. And if the prenuptial agreement is drafted artfully, it will say that that increase in value is protected. But what happens when the spouse inherits that business, sells it, gets proceeds, and then invests that into a new, and maybe doesn't invest all of it, but takes seed money from that, invests in a new business or three new businesses that then, you know, some of them flop, some of them succeed, and now we've got a different tracing issue. Mm-hmm. That's something we come across all the time.
Mm-hmm. And one of the biggest things, and we talked about this previously, but it's worth reiterating, in my opinion, when you are talking to a client, especially if you're in a prenup situation, emphasizing the importance of maintaining documents. Most financial institutions will retain documents for 7 years. 7 years is not a very long time to be married. And if you are not maintaining those documents yourself, then it very well, you could have a clear as day, it's your separate property. But if you can't overcome that burden and prove it with the documents, then there's really, our hands get tied as lawyers, because all of a sudden, Mrs. or, you know, whomever the spouse is, forgets that that's how this money came to be. And if you don't have a document to show that, then it's he said, she said, and the presumption is going to be hard to overcome.